I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at TangiLawTeam.com and let's get to work.
I'd like to call the Tangipahoa Parish School Board meeting to order. If we can have roll call, Ms. Cindy.
Ms. Richards?
Present.
Mr. Toler?
Here.
Ms. Abrams?
Here.
Mr. Westmoreland?
Present.
Mr. Duncan?
Here.
Mr. Bush?
Here.
Mr. Moore?
Here.
Ms. Simmons?
Here.
Ms. Dominguez?
Present.
At this time, I'm going to introduce Ms. Dominguez, and she's going to introduce our patriotic portion of our program this afternoon.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our Tangipahoa Parish School Board meeting tonight. As what's become a protocol for us this year, we do our openings now on the screen instead of having our children come, but we're so happy tonight that we have a lot of our students here, and we hope to get back to that tradition. But we've invited Champ Cooper to come, and they're going to lead us in the pledge, and also the Star Spangled Banner. So if you would stand, please, and join in that.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light, well, so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight.
Moving on to item D, consider approval of the board minutes from April 20th, 2021. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Mr. Toler, second by Ms. Simmons. Vote, Ms. Cindy.
Voting is open. Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
We're going to move on to our awards and recognitions. Both A and B are going to be announced by Ms. Dominguez. A is recognizing Jaden Hawk for the 2021 State Bowling Champion.
At this time, I'd like to ask Ms. Jaden to come up with her coach.
Thank you.
It's always an honor when we are allowed such wonderful students to participate as in our parish and in our schools. And we're honored at Hammond High to have a wonderful state champion bowler. And tonight her coach is going to just tell you a little bit about her, and we wanted to recognize her for her accomplishments as a state champion. And then we also have a little certificate for you as well.
Okay. One thing I can say about Jade, and I've never seen anyone who was more willing to put in the work necessary to improve and to get where she's at. And at the same time, just you really have to know her, just know how humble she is, and in my mind, just the true definition of a champion.
I'd also like to recognize another state champion, and this one's a little bit closer to my own heart, as I had a son that was also the state champion, and this is a pole vaulting winner, Mr. Beau Domain, and his coach is coming with him. So we're honored to have you as a pole vaulter and as a winner in our parish, and we wish you all the best in whatever else that you may continue to do. I think you want to speak, right?
Yeah, I wanted to tell you a couple things about Beau. He's a junior at Hammond High, and he is a two-time All-American voted on by the United States Track and Field Association. He's the state champion in 5A in pole vault and jumped 17 and a quarter inches, which is the third best jump in the nation this year. So we're really proud of Beau. We're expecting really great things out of him as well next year. One thing about Beau is he works really hard. He's a really good teammate to all of the kids that are on our track team. We have a young pole vaulter that's a girl. He helps with her a lot when she gets a little anxious, but he does a great job. He's a class act, and I've been really fortunate to be able to coach him the last 2 years. He also just found out recently that he will be going to Eugene, Oregon, in conjunction with the United States Track and Field Olympic Trials. He will be jumping in the high school one that takes place around the same time. So we're real proud of Beau, and thankful to have an opportunity to coach him. Thank you.
Make sure to put Robin next to him.
Yeah.
We can have the parents of these two athletes please stand and be recognized. All right, we're going to move on to C. We're going to recognize the 2021 Senior Superlative Club members. Mr. Jinko.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming tonight. I have a pretty cool job, but this is one of my favorite parts of my job, working with this group, being able to you know, stand up here and look at this group with the you know, Shark Tank. I love Shark Tank. That's one of my favorite shows. You know, you could have the next person here standing in front of Shark Tank making millions of dollars. Remember, that's Genco, G-E-N-C-O. you could have the individual that cures cancer. You could have the individual that creates something that allows individuals that maybe are paralyzed and so forth to walk again. It is an unlimited potential what we have in this room. So to the students, congratulations. To the parents and family members, thank you for choosing Tangipahoa Parish School System. We hope that we have lived up to your expectations. As this group continues to go forward, we ask that you remember Tangipahoa Parish, come back home to us. If you go out of state to college, come back and work here. If any of you want to teach, you have a job in 4 years when you graduate. So we'll let you sign the contract tonight. If you're thinking about teaching, we'll take care of that tonight. So we'll start with, as we call your name, we ask you that you come up. Unfortunately, we have, you know, it looks like a lot of individuals were not here tonight. We do have a PowerPoint, so we'll let the PowerPoint run through for those particular individuals and for everyone that's here also. So our first student tonight is from Amead High School, Mr. Marcus Brown, plans to attend Southeastern Louisiana University and major in finance. Mr. Marcus, come on up, sir.
We're doing it, okay.
Next, we'll move to Hammond High School. First individual is Mr. Ty Donnelly. I don't think Mr. Donnelly is here. Next individual is Mr. Justice Kelly. Plans on going to Xavier University, major in data science, become a veterinarian. Mr. Jacob Kinchin plans to go to LSU and major in computer engineering. Ms. Mary Mayu. Mr. William Milleron. Cheyenne Morgan. Adam Sawyer. Noah Thompson. School. Savannah Cruz. Leah Peavy. And Roger Robertson. Plans to attend LSU, major in pre-law and future plans to become a defender of criminal justice. Now we'll move to Ponchatoula High School. Isabella Bado. Virginia Bell. Plans to attend Southeastern Louisiana University, pre-med, biology, sports medicine surgeon.
You may want to stay around, you got some stuff coming up next. We're working on getting you a job.
Marini Beater. Plans to go to Agnes Scott College, major in English, and pursue a career in journalism. Kenneth Boudreaux. Kylie Burks. Branson Calinato. Lilani Celestine. Carolyn Cranford. Plans to attend Southeastern Louisiana University, major in nursing, and pursue a career in nursing. Preston Davidson. Clarissa Height. Andrea Kinchin. Anne LaCour. Plans to attend LSU, major in microbiology / pre-dentistry, and attend college, dental school, and become an orthodontist. Cole LaCour. Plans to attend Louisiana State University, major in medical physics / pre-med, attend medical school, and become a radiologist. Jake Leitz, Bryce Lipscomb, Maya Madrigal, Claudia Ola, Noah Polland, Jacob Propies. Hopefully I got that right, Jacob. Jacob Propes, plans to attend Louisiana State University, major in fine arts and digital art. Lucas Hussinger, Jake Savannah, and Cheyenne White. I would be remiss if we did not ask parents, guardians, guide, you know, support systems, if you'll please stand up, and we definitely, you deserve a round of applause. Again, congratulations to everyone. Wish you the best of luck in your future, and you definitely make us hashtag Tangi proud. Thank you.
Do it over here. All right. All right, we're going to move on to E, recognize the recipients of the Ennis Jake Bailey Jr. Above and Beyond Award. Ms. Simmons?
What about D?
Oh, did I skip? I'm sorry. It was highlighted.
Did you skip one?
I did. Recognize the recipients of the John Williams Scholarship Award, Jake Bailey Award, and WDS Scholar Award.
And
Mr.
We'd like
Jackson and Ms. Simmons?
Yeah, and Ms. Reverend Jackson, and of course, Ms. Stilley and Ms. Robin, and then also to Coach Donald Dykes. And then the recipients of the award would be Sophia Hanna, Chris Norman, and then we have Coach Dominguez. Josh, is he here? So we'd like for all of you all to come forth too.
I just want to say that I believe that we have the greatest students in the United States of America, right here in Tangipahoa. What else can I say? Do you believe that? If you believe that, would you recognize all of our young people with a standing ovation? Would you stand with me? Give them a standing ovation. Let them know how much we love them, and we know that they are going to make us proud. Thank you.
And
that's the end of the sermon for tonight. At this time, Hammond, we will start with
Coach Dykes, do you want to come up and explain the purpose here?
Good evening. My name is Donald Dykes, and I go back to 1974 when I was a senior at Hammond High School, and on a situation like this, and a night like this, and an occasion like this, I was an outstanding athlete in high school. Academically, I struggled, okay, a lot of why. But thing that I never forgot was that Mr. Jake Bailey, who was a school board member at that time, he reached out and he gave me a whole bunch of love. And that was over 40 years ago. And I have never forgotten about that. And since that time, Miss Billy Simmons has given me a bunch of love as well. So I am just giving back the way it was given to me. Okay, and these awards is a combination of Mr. Jake Bailey and John Wheaton. Okay, and this is what we have tonight, ma'am. Okay.
So we have Sophia Hanna. And let's read it out. Jake Bailey Award presented to Sophia Hanna in Ponchatoula High School for academic success and athletic achievement 2021, and also a $500 scholarship. So, Sophia. Are you with Sophia?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. All right. You want to say something, Jeff?
Yeah, I guess so.
All right. I've been assistant coach for boys for 9 years. What coach? Under coach. And I took over the girls this year. One of the crazy things. I had Gigi, which is Virginia Bell. And Sophia was also one of my seniors. You know, I had a good senior class. And it's one of the people you can always count on in the classroom, out the classroom. And we appreciate her. And so in the classroom, out the classroom, we're glad to have her. And I'm glad to see her. Continue her success through college, and she's going to be an education major. So where's Mr. Jinko? So we're glad to have her, and I'm glad to see her, but I hate to see her leave. One of them things. So.
And the other $500 scholarship is Chris Norman. Chris Norman, Ponchatoula High School, for academic success and athletic achievement, 2021, and here's your $500 scholarship. All right, congratulations.
Okay, you want to take a picture of this real quick?
Hammond High, Natalie Harris, Natalie, please. Natalie Harris is standing before us with a 3.98 GPA. Also, Dante Taylor. Jacavius Callahan, Kitwood High. Let me just say that this is a scholarship at large. Coach Dykes never really brags on himself, but Mr. Jake Bailey, who was a longtime school board member, did that a long time ago. Of course, Coach Dykes graduated from Hammond High, went on to Southeastern Louisiana University, was drafted in the NFL by the Jets, played for a couple of teams there, and I want to say that he has done much for this community. Would you give him a hand, please? Jacaria Cooper, would you come? This is Coach Dykes' grandson, and let me say that now, Coach Dykes talked about being such a great athlete in school, and let me just say that his grandson is also Madison Prep Academy, a 3.8 GPA. So not only is he a great athlete, and he took that after his grandfather, but he's not struggling with academics. 3.8. Once you put the mic in front of me, I can't seem to walk away. Let me just say this, that this is a testament to not only our superintendent, come on, the superintendent, our board members, our teachers, our support people. That's why we have such great students here in Tangipahoa Parish. Thank you.
Now moving to E. Recognize the recipients of the Enos Jake Bailey Jr. Above and Beyond Award. Ms. Simmons.
We have two recipients tonight, and Mr. Ron Jinko, who I'll call Baby Jinko. And then we have Ms. Kirkland. Is she going to come up for this? Just you? Okay. Okay, the two that are going to receive the Enos F. Jake Bailey Above and Beyond Award is going to be Chris Moody. Would you come forth? And Austin Powell. I don't want to read what's on the certificate. Certificate of recognition. This certificate is awarded to Chris Moody, Moody Law Firm, for his contributions to the district's Cookies for Caregivers, and in recognition for being the recipient of the Enos F. Jake Bailey above junior, above and beyond award, and the same thing for Austin Powell, and you also get a special note from me as well as a gift certificate to a restaurant. And what I want to say about tonight's recipients is really special tonight because Jake Bailey, my late husband, was on the board 28 years, and Mr. Moody was there then, and so I know he's smiling in heaven that you're receiving this award, and definitely, I don't think you were born. But your grandfather, Tank Powell, was born, and he was a very, very close friend of Jake Bailey, and your father was born, Little Henry, right? And so they're all connected to the Jake Bailey way back and also today. So let me give you your awards. Austin.
The Tangipahoa Parish School System Smart Cookies started and kind of mirrored Mr. Jeremy Ehrlich from Pennsylvania, who decided to make cookies and give them to the caregivers during the pandemic. So this made its way around, I don't know if it was social media or something, and some of our employees came to us and said, look, you know, we know our employees are having a tough time. We just want to do a little special something for them to let them know we thank them for all that they do day in and day out to make our system great and to help our students. So they came up with the TPSS Smart Cookies and delivered cookies to over 2,800 employees. Every school and every branch office we have, they took a day and delivered cookies to those particular individuals. And we would be remiss if we did not identify and recognize that group of individuals that worked tirelessly to do this. Some of them are here, so if I call your name, please stand up and take a little bow and get a little applause for you. Miss Kara Busby. Miss Carla Kirkland. Miss Ashley Adamson. Dr. Linda Baker. Miss Donna Castiglione. Miss Deborah Davis. Miss Robin Davis. Miss Donna Lanier. Miss Sheila Luther. Miss Kim Notriana. Miss Hope Terry. Miss Rachel Terrio. And Miss Ann Trappe. The ladies from the TPSS Smart Cookies could not have done the things that they've done without the help of Mr. Austin Powell and Powell and Associates and Mr. Chris Moody with the Moody Law Firm. So we'd like to give them another round of applause.
I don't think Mr. Jinko announced, they actually bake these cookies. They didn't go buy them in a store. They actually did a labor of love with these cookies every time they delivered them. Before we move on to our next recipient, if we can recognize all the parents from the Jake Bailey Award with the WDS Scholarship Award, with that Mr. Jackson and Ms. Simmons awarded, all of the scholars, if y'all could, the parents, if y'all could please stand up to these students.
Well, Austin Powell's dad's here too. I think Henry Powell is down there. There you go.
Now we're going to recognize the enhanced partnership with North Oaks Sports Medicine Program. Mr. Jingo.
And I know for our senior superlatives, the doctors and nurses, make sure you write these names down. After you finish medical school, these are the people you want to talk to for a job. And for our attorney, you know, these are the kind of papers that you have to go through and make sure everything's okay for us. So, good evening, everyone. At this time, we would just like to, thank our partner, North Oaks, for all the work that they help us with. This is going to be a three-year partnership for the sports medicine program to coordinate with our local high schools and middle schools. We'll talk about the athletic training services. It outlines the education, prevention, and care programs, and does have a clause of exclusivity that we are very fine with because we want to make sure that we thank North Oaks and, you know, we'd be a good partner with them. So at this time, I'm going to turn it over to Ms. Jessica Bennett.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I just want to thank you guys for allowing us to be here. If I have not formally met you, my name is Jessica Bennett. I am the Vice President of our Orthopedic Service Line at North Oaks Health System. With me, I would like to introduce Reagan Johnson. She is the Director of Operations of our Orthopedic Service Line. And then also Ms. Rebecca Trulette. She is our Clinical Supervisor of our Sports Medicine Program. So first of all, I just wanted to thank each and every one of you guys for our continued partnership that we have between the Tangipahoa Parish School System and North Oaks Health System. And then I wanted to take a moment just to identify a few things of what this partnership actually brings to our community. So first of all, by going with this partnership between Tangipahoa Parish and North Oaks, we are able to put in a nationally certified athletic trainer in every single one of our high schools. Mm-hmm. With this, they're under the supervision of an orthopedic sports medicine fellowship trained Dr. Katie Morris. We recently implemented on-site physicals. I think if you've ever been to North Oaks physicals, it was always that big day and everybody came in. We kind of heard some feedback that our schools wanted it on-site. So what we do is we offer that on-site to all of our high schools and we serve grades 7 through 12 for those physicals. We offer sports-specific emergency planning and policy implementation. We have an all-encompassing concussion management program, which is something that's been very significant within the sports medicine realm. We have an after-hour sports medicine clinic for rehabilitation, free of charge to our athletes. And then we also have priority scheduling with our athletes within any North Oaks Health System area. So in addition to medical management, some things that you guys may not know is this partnership also offers an educational opportunity to both our students and our sports leadership teams. This is through our Medical Explorer program, so our students can actually come into our facility and not only shadow medical professions, but what people don't realize, we have a lot of non-medical professionals that work at North Oaks as well. So they can kind of get a wide gamut if they are looking for something outside of that. Another thing that it offers is we have experts in the field, so if your schools, your classrooms need an expert to come in and teach the students, All your principals have to do, all your teachers have to do, give us a call. We'll definitely get that going for you guys. And then the last thing is, because of the continuing education requirements for our coaches, we offer 2 annual coach seminars yearly so that they can come in. It's a full day where they come in and they just get education. Sometimes it's very sports specific, sometimes it's injury specific. We get their feedback on what they want to hear, and then we get the experts in there to train them. So also, as identified in the brochure, what you may not, or we have the brochures back there, but one thing that we have recently implemented within sports medicine is sports nutrition and sports performance. Within these areas, our specialists are able to offer one-on-one custom programs for our athletes and teams so that they can improve their performance and wellness. While we currently offer team performance packages, we also look to offer one-on-one performance training within the next year. Another future goal that we have and that we have started, Rebecca has definitely manned for us, is we are looking to create safe sports schools throughout our parish so that all of our high schools have this certain certification. That's something that sets us apart from other parishes within our state. With all of this, I would just like to personally thank you guys on behalf of North Oaks Health System for the continued partnership and allowing us the opportunity to serve our community that we so much love as the official healthcare provider for our athletes and our students. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much. At this time, we're going to take about a 2-3 minute break.
If I can just interject
sure.
1 minute, please. I would be remiss. I know when Miss Jessica announced Miss Rebecca Truyet, the name was not familiar. But before she was a Truyet, she was a Schnatterbox. So that is Mr. Brett Schnatterbox's daughter.
Now, we'll take about a 2 or 3 minute break so everyone can leave and we'll finish our meeting up. If you want to take pictures, you're more than welcome to.
Channel 17. Proudly serving the Florida parishes.
All right, we're going to move on to the academic update with Dr. Frisell. Is she here?
Yep.
I'm still here.
Oh, she's still here.
Room clear out. This whole academic update.
Goodbye. Actually, the Jessica who just presented from North Oaks, when she started talking, I was transported back to Hammond High. She was one of my students. I didn't recognize her until she started talking. And instead of hearing all that great stuff, I heard Miss Facile, and then whatever excuse followed that, so I had to go tease her. So it was nice to have a break. But I have a little presentation. Do we have it?
Yeah, I do. Okay. I did something, and...
And it just went boop.
And...
That doesn't even look familiar, Miss...
Yeah, it doesn't, okay. Does
there
it?
We go.
There we go.
Do you want to give me...
Yes, ma'am.
So I just wanted to share with you all tonight, because you're going to hear this word, accelerating learning, accelerate, because that is the new LDOE real-time tutoring strategy. And the department actually released this in February. We had an initial training on it. And it's not that it's something just totally new. We have structures. It's more of a refinement of how we do interventions. And so I wanted to tell you a little bit about it tonight, because you're constantly going to hear accelerate learning or accelerate time, where we used to say intervention time. So I just wanted to share with you a little bit of the overview. And just to kind of sum up a little bit about acceleration, I was recently on a national call, and it seems like we're all saying the same thing. We just may use different words. So where in Louisiana we say accelerate, in some other parts they're still saying closing the gap, or they say taking care of unfinished learning. And you know, we don't really like that term, unfinished learning, because sometimes it was unfinished instruction. Because of the disruption due to the pandemic, you know, it wasn't that students didn't learn it. Some of it, because of that interruption, it was presented to them in a different format, or we had to really package stuff together in order to keep up with the pacing. So I want to share with you, this is probably the most important slide, what is acceleration, but I want you to look first at what it is not. Acceleration does not mean we're going to skip content or compress it to rush through it. It does not mean that we're going to teach a skill in isolation, which in one of the groups I was talking to, they said, what's the difference in remediation and intervention? And that, like, that'll spark an academic conversation for the ages if you have the right people in the room. But in the way I view it, remediation is after the fact. You've gone through the course, we have your test, you did not score proficient, we remediate a whole set of skills or a whole set of content. When we talk about intervention, we mean intervene before the failure happens. Intervene before the end of the unit. So that's kind of our focus with accelerating our schedules. We want to catch students in real time to intervene on whatever skill it is that student's struggling with for that unit. And it may not be, again, unfinished learning on their part. It may be instruction. And the example LDOE uses, which I think is a really good one, might be in a unit last year in my third grade year, maybe I missed that piece of instruction, maybe like me. I tell y'all all the time, fractions, I missed it. Somewhere along the line, I missed the whole thing on fractions, and I need to go find intervention on that even today. So if it were Lisa Facile, and they gave me a pre-module test, and I needed to be able to do fractions for that unit, my daily dose of intervention or acceleration time would be on the skill I need to complete that unit successfully. not wait till the unit's over and go, oh my God, Lisa couldn't do fractions, so she failed the whole thing. That's what the intervention strategy of Accelerate's really about. And so it sounds like, oh yeah, that is great. The problem, the dilemma is in scheduling that, and I'm gonna share the pillars of that with you next. You can see what acceleration is. It is a type of intervention. It is proactive, deliberate planning, which is what we're gonna talk about, how we plan to do that deliberate planning. And most importantly, and that's the big check mark at the bottom, it's targeted and individualized. And we have to put a system in place so that we could figure out Lisa doesn't know fractions before the end of the module. So these are the core pillars of the whole strategy, Accelerate. The intentional structure. We've had the intentional structure at Tangipahoa Parish. Years ago, we started with Dr. Williams and Ms. Hamilton, and I'm sure when Ms. Dilley was here, it became a requirement that we build in intervention time into our schedules. So, you know, we've had the structure. Why hasn't it magically closed all the gaps? Well, the other two pillars are very important. One of them's high quality materials. So when we adopt a tier one curriculum, one of the processes that we go through is the fact that we may have pieces of resources that don't align to that tier one curriculum anymore. So some of the things we were using for intervention in the past might have been a program. You might have heard a program name. Well, when we switched to that tier one, it didn't align anymore. We didn't have a clear alignment with this program for this part of the unit that Lisa is struggling in. So we were lacking high quality materials. And this is when it hit me 2 years ago. We went into a room and, you know, some students had just finished their intervention time. Well, the teacher was doing the best the teacher could. They took some of their tier one materials that's for the core instruction and they pre-taught it to the student before the unit started. That was a great concept around what Accelerate is, because we really want to front load for students when they don't know something. We want to do that during that time. The problem was now the kid was in the core instruction and they already had that handout, whatever, for their intervention. So, you know, we're looking and we're going, this is the problem. So we've been trying to figure out this problem. So this, again, was a benefit of the pandemic. Because of schools closing down, our vendors of the Tier 1 curriculum, they really got busy working on the high quality materials that align to the curriculum we're using. So for example, you may have heard this year EQIP or NSYNC. Well, EQIP was what we purchased for our 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th that gives you that pre-module assessment. And it tells the teacher, this is what Lisa needs to work on. And it even gave the little plan that you could take and go work with Lisa on that plan. So we had that. We didn't have the assessment piece to check it after I supported Lisa. And they finished that full cycle, and we're actually gonna purchase that next year. It's called Affirm. And it's not like when you hear assessment, this is one of the really important things that we're working on. Assessment's not a negative word. You can over assess if you're not looking for something specific. This is really small. This might be like 6 questions, and it tells the teacher immediately, here's the key things Lisa doesn't know for this particular module. So we were really missing that high quality material piece. We were trying to package it ourselves. The other thing that LDOE is doing in addition to our tier one vendors is they hired content leader level teachers from around the state to write lessons. And it's all up on their website now, and I'm gonna show you a picture of that. So we don't have to go make it anymore. They have unit one. Here's some teacher-facing lessons, here's some student-facing lessons to support this Accelerate time. The other part of it is effective instruction. And you know, the best example I can use is when you're trying to like support everybody, you're just trying to divide and conquer. What Accelerate says is it's more important to have the right person with that group than to have everybody with that group. So they give us some strategies like maybe I can't tutor Lisa every day on fractions, but I want that content leader who specializes in math to tutor Lisa. So Lisa's going to get tutoring 2 days a week because I need that person to do this other group 2 days a week. And it's about making that balance happen until you get everybody who can teach that acceleration time at the rigorous level that's required to get that student accelerated. So those are the three structures that we're really focused on with our schools. And you know, part of our big principal launch in the summer is we kind of give them these strategies. Now we've been releasing this. LDOE came up with a wonderful document in partnership with DM Group that's best practices. And when we read it, I was so excited. I was like, you know what, we're doing most of these best practices, but there's a refinement part that has to happen. So every week our principals, they get the whole document, but then every week we highlight pieces of it for them. And then for the teacher newsletter, we highlight the same pieces so teachers can see too, these are what the best practices are that we're gonna be focusing on, and accelerates one of those best practices. This is a cycle, you know, all of us are familiar with. We want to diagnose, figure out what the problem is, plan. Those are the plans that are being prepared for us. We want an effective teacher to deliver it, and then we're going to monitor, and we're going to see. We just worked with Lisa on fractions. Let's give Lisa a mid-module assessment. Could she do the fraction? Let's keep Lisa moving. It's about keeping me moving through the unit at the pace of my counterparts, but also giving me what I need to keep running. And I wish I was an athlete, I could give you a better example. I don't have an athletic example, but it's like coaching you up to get to that end. And the cycle, I just kind of gave you an example of what would be from a hat. It would be equip, affirm would be our kind of our assessment. And then we have InSync, which are videos that our teachers could use in lessons in addition to what LDOE has created. LDOE is still working on ELA. They did release, this is what we're using in our summer program, the Accelerate lessons, because we want these kids, if you're going into third grade, we want to be working on with you on what you're going to need in third grade. We don't want to go spend all our time back in second grade. We want to start getting you ready for third grade, and that's for every grade level. I'm really passionate about eighth grade. We really wanted some of our high school teachers to teach those eighth grade kids to front load the content that they would need to be ready for that ELA unit for that math module. And this is what it looks like on LDOE's site. And this is up publicly. Anybody can go click. They have a whole launching pad called Accelerate that kind of gives the why that I went over. And then they have where you can click and it has the lessons. And one of the things that they did that was really great for us is they made a separate package for summer. Because as soon as I was listening, I was like, well, great, we'll use them all up in the summer, and then we won't have anything fresh for the school year. But no, they did a separate package for the summer, and we'll have fresh lessons for the school year. And the other thing that we're doing is we have applied to be in the Accelerate cohort with LDOE, where we're choosing three of our schools that we're going to particularly focus on. We're going to do this with all of our schools because we already have the structure. But there's going to be a feeder pattern of schools that we have a coordinator who particularly makes sure the implementation and gathers data. Because LDOE wants to study what is the impact of using this real-time tutoring strategy at a group of schools very focused that they collect data on throughout the year. So we've applied for that. We haven't heard about it yet. And the other thing that we're doing as a district is the group that helped write the scheduling guidance, DM group, we've signed up a team of 8, 4 from the district and one principal from each of our learning communities. They are participating in regional technical guidance on how do you make this work? Because it's nice to talk about, but when you get to the bottom of what does this look like in a schedule, and everybody's schedule doesn't look the same, we have this specialty group working with us, and he calls and he says, what are you working on in Tangi? What do you want to know more about? And then they design our training around that. So we had our launch of that today, which today it was just going back over the best practices. And our next session is going to be one-on-one with us saying, you've heard it, where are you at, what can we do? So we feel really supported in that implementation. But you're just going to hear the word accelerate a lot. So I wanted to make sure you kind of had what that strategy looked like as you hear it throughout the school year. Any questions or comments on Accelerate?
Thank you.
As much talking as you've done today, you ought to be exhausted, but it was a great presentation.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And we do have to just brag a little bit more on Dr. Fusell. Tomorrow she graduates with her doctorate.
Thank you so much.
We're lucky to have you.
Yes, we are.
All right, we're going to move on to our superintendent's report. Can you talk as much as Ms. Fusell can? Committee reports. My browser keeps moving. I don't know why I keep going down so much. Okay, here we go. Capital Outlay Committee of the Whole, May 12th. Do I have a motion to accept?
I'll make a motion to accept.
President.
All right, Mr. Bush.
Ms. Dominguez can make that
motion. All right, Ms. Dominguez, second. Mr. Bush made the motion. Call for a vote, Ms. Cindy.
Mr. Bush made the motion?
Yes.
Okay.
Just 1 second. Voting is open.
We haven't gotten it yet.
To what?
There it went.
Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Our Finance Committee report from May 12, 2020. Do I have a motion to accept?
Motion to accept.
Mr. Westmoreland made a motion.
Second.
Second by Ms. Dominguez. Vote, Ms. Cindy.
Voting is open.
Again, it moved on me again.
I don't see it, Ms. Cindy, but yes for me.
Yes, Mr. Toler.
Me too, I don't see it.
Yes, Mr. Bush. Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Now moving on to our superintendent's report.
Thank you, Madam President. Item 5A, we'd ask the board to consider approval to refer the remaining policies of Section I and L and policies EFA, technology and internet use, and KIC, that's distribution, posting of promotional materials, to the policy committee.
Move to refer.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Duncan, second by Mr. Toler. Any questions? Call for a vote, Ms. Cindy.
Voting is open. Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Item 5B, we'd like to ask the board to consider approval of the rebranded district logo. And I'm asking Ms. Jenkins if she'll bring that up on the screen. This is a copy of our proposed new district logo. And on the next slide, there are three elements in which we kept from our old logo: the color, the blue color, the stars are embedded, as well as in the new one as the old, and also the T that stands for Tangipahoa, not Tom Toler. And also you can see the other elements that are included here. We have the burning torch that really shows and is a symbol of commitment to excellence in education. We have seven stars at the crown of the shield, and that represents our seven high schools across our parish. We have book pages at the bottom of the shield or the crest to, you know, represent the Book of Knowledge. T, of course, for Tangipahoa. We have the historic Louisiana font. We found out that the school system was established October 2nd. October the 3rd of 1896. So we included the establishment of when our school system first started in our logo. And then also underneath the shield and the book pages, you'll see two olive branches that are crossing as a symbol of peace. And the color scheme and the olive leaves represent the skin tone, the various skin tones within our system as we focus on inclusion and equity for all. If you look at the next slide, you'll see variations of the logo depending on, you know, how it would be used, whether it's on a colored background. You know, you may see the white letters and white shield. So the following pages are basically the same with some variations. And so tonight I ask the board to consider approval of our new district logo.
Do I have a motion?
I'll make that motion to approve the logo.
Ms. Bailey has, Simmons has approved, and second by Ms. Janice. Any comments by the board?
Well, I'm pretty excited about it, like Dr. Hurst and Mr. Snodmike and Mr. Jenko. We on board, Ms. Stilley.
Thank you, Mr. Bush.
Anyone else?
I was until you told me the T was.
Not Tom Toller. All right, call for a vote, Ms. Cindy.
Voting is open.
Looks nice.
Thank you.
Cypress tree would have been better with the moss hanging on.
And the swamp.
In the swamp, but that's just. You
know. Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Thank you.
Item 3C, general updates. No updates for tonight. Thank you.
Ooh. All right, moving to 6. Other board actions. Consider approval of the resolution authorizing the execution and delivery of the amendment of the restated cooperative endeavor agreement between the Educational Facility Improvements District of Parish of Tangipahoa, State of Louisiana, and the Parish School Board of Parish of Tangipahoa, State of Louisiana. Mr. Schnatterbach.
Madam President, before we take that up from Mr. Schnatterbach, I did want to recognize and thank a fellow Educational Facilities Improvement District board member for being here, Trayvon Cooper. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Trayvon.
Thank you for your service to the district.
Thank you, Mr. Duncan. Thank you, Mr. President, board members. I'm excited about this. This is a lot of hard work right here. So what presented before the board today is a resolution with the Education Facility Improvement District related with the successful passage of our half penny sales tax on April 24th. The obligations to the school board under this cooperative endeavor agreement is to receive from the district the proceeds of the sales tax. So I'd ask y'all to approve the resolution so we can go ahead and receive those proceeds when they come in. There are some other obligations, make people available from the school district to the district to assist them in their needs. That's mainly the collection of the sales tax with our sales tax collector. And then the reimbursement of any expenditures by the members of the board or by the district and related with the collection of that tax. But the real responsibility is to collect the proceeds.
And spend it in accordance with?
That's correct, yes.
Spend
it in accordance with the tax proposition, yes. Which is for salaries and benefits for all our employees.
I'll second the motion.
Yeah. Mr. Duncan made the motion. Mr. Mingo, second. Any other questions about this? Call for a vote, Ms. Cindy.
Voting is open.
Yes, for me.
Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Are we going to go to personal privilege? Mr. Bush, you want to start us off?
Ma'am?
You want to start off? Have any comments?
I try to mention a special graduate every week that I can remember. I have to say Devontae went number 10 in the NFL draft. That happened since we met last at the Philadelphia Eagles, I think. I sent him a message. It'll be cold up there, boy. He said he's ready. Kim Monkey. She was 2 years younger than me in high school, but Hammond High was on the map doing her 4 years back at LSU, which is as a head girls basketball coach, another Tangipahoa Parish graduate. And so if you just keep going with all these people, again, you could be anything you want to be and graduate from a public high school. One other thing on a kind of a sad note, we have three gentlemen that are pitchers that are back on that wall that were board presidents in the past. Tank Jinko, Henry Sibley, and we lost another one Friday, Mr. Robert Case, 67 years old. And so three really great guys who I knew fairly well. And if we model our lives about how we care for children and care for education after these three guys, we'll have a great school system. I want to remember Mr. Kays' family.
Thank you. Ms. Sandra?
Yeah, I served on the board with Robert Kays, and he was an outstanding board member. He was very informed, very vocal, and he kept us on track, and he knew the Robert's rules of order. I mean, if you didn't get it right, he'd fix it real quick, like, and he'd stop you. So he was outstanding in that respect. But he was also a great friend to many of us, and we certainly do mourn his passing, and our prayers are with his family. Also, too, you know, we thought it was the end of the world when Southeastern wasn't able to allow us to have our graduations there, but it wasn't the end of the world. It was kind of a beginning of a kind of a new era here, because we found places to have our graduations, and I went to several, and they worked out really, really well. It just goes to show you, when you're creative and you're willing to work it out, you could find a way where there seems to be no way. And we made a way, and it was very effective, and we had great graduations. So I'm appreciative of our leadership there.
Miss, I hate to interrupt, but I have to say one more thing about a LaRonja High School graduate who on May 7th, I think, pitched a no-hitter, Wayne Molly. Let's don't forget about
that. Yes, can't forget about our Mr. Molly.
Forget about that. Been to numerous NBA teams, 34 years old, and I think that was only 302nd no-hitter pitch in Major League history. So congratulations to the LaRonja High School graduate, Wayne Molly, on pitching a no-hitter.
That's right. Thank you.
Mr. Duncan?
So, Mr. Bush mentioned this, but this past weekend, Hammond alum and Coach Kim Mulkey got inducted to the Hall of Fame. And within hours of her returning home, she sent a special message to us. And I'm going to yield my personal privilege over to her for a moment. And I'll let Ms.
Hi, everyone associated with Natalbany and Hammond Educators. I want to give a shout out to you for a tremendous job you have done under very, very abnormal circumstances, having to deal with COVID and to continue to educate young people. You make me proud. Being from Tangipahoa Parish, I'm proud of you guys. Go Tigers.
Wow, that's awesome.
And yes, that was how I was going to end it, was to say, and of course, we are very proud of her, and just glad that she is back home and part of our community. And it was just very nice of her to share that message with us. And of course, I'll share that recording on my Facebook page, and y'all are welcome to help make sure it gets circulated out to all of the educators in our community, because I know she wants them to hear that.
Thank you so much for sharing that. Ms. Janice?
I'd just like to say that we also have another signer, Shaheem Carter. If you're watching the Texans, make sure that you look out for Shaheem Carter. So we're proud of him for him signing. Ms. Nottebach, I want to say, yeah, we're happy to receive the money, but we need you all to continue to shop at home so that we can continue to pay our employees. Thank you.
Mr. Glenn?
I'd just like to say congratulations to all the seniors, and me and Mr. Bush are looking forward to see what this group can bring to our parish.
Amen.
Yes, definitely. Mr. Toler, you good? Mr. Dominguez?
Yes, I congratulate all of our graduating seniors.
we did have some really great graduations this year, even if they weren't at Southeastern. So we're proud of our employees for all the hard work they put into actually putting these graduations on. I know we had some weather issues in the mix of all that, but they succeeded, and we congratulate all the kids as they move on to higher ed or whatever their field may be. We are also proud of, we've had several signers of all athletic activities and college scholarships across this parish. So we've got a lot of great students that we're proud to move on. I'm really happy about that. And with the logo, I think it's quite an improvement over our previous. I think it's moved us up a level, which is what we're moving. We're moving up a level. And I think it really reflects a positive change and positive movement for our parish. So I appreciate the hard work on that. It's very good.
Mr. Moore?
Okay, first of all, I would like to congratulate the seniors. Congratulate all of the award winners that we had in here tonight. I think it's the most excellent achievement for all of them in every aspect of the celebrations that we've had tonight. I think if I had one word to say, it would be for the teachers, the administration, and well, congratulations to Mr. Lee, you got an addition to your administration. but to the teachers, to all of the employees, that this is all about our children. I mean, everything that we're here for tonight, everything that has happened tonight is all because we are responsible for educating the children in the parish. And if I was going to give any sentiment or advice, it would be to understand that these are children. They've got issues, and they will always have issues. And we have just got to find the strength, and I pray that God will give us the wisdom and the understanding to help each and every one of them. And I think that it's a lot simpler than we might consider. We may have to, I mean, the efforts that we have to put in to do that. But I think that the solutions are simple. I think these children just need to know that they matter, know that we care. And that will be a tremendous start. So,
thank you so much.
My prayers go with you.
Well, I would just like to congratulate our board. We have finished another school year, going into our third year as school board members. And guys, we've accomplished a lot. We've gone through a pandemic. We've ended a desegregation case in our term. We've passed a half-cent sales tax for all of our employees to get a 7% raise. We all received numerous phone calls throughout the year, whether it's complaining or praise or help fix this or did you know that? And we all do it because we want what's best for the children of Tangipahoa Parish. And I just want to thank each and every one of you for working so hard on this board, because you put the effort out there to make what our parish is as well. So thank you all. So if anybody else has anything else to say?
I want to ask Janice a question before I say anything. I think he's skipping somebody. Yeah, we had a relay team from Kentwood High School win a state championship, I'm thinking, just 2 weeks ago. I think the coach was here tonight.
Sorry. A relay team that doesn't have a track. Am I correct? They keep winning these awards. We might have to do that.
That's right.
Yeah. All right, guys.
And you probably do need to also just mention there's a lot of people in our state that are hurting from floodwaters and school districts that are suffering. So,
yes, yeah. East Baton Rouge, I know, is closing their schools this week. So keep everybody in your prayers as far as the flooding going on in that part of the state. Anything else from anyone else? If not, call this meeting adjourned.
Yeah.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.